This show is made for Noggin by Nick Jr.
I can feel that crazy craving for honeycomb.
Honeycomb, honeycomb, me want honeycomb.
I can't concentrate and the craving hits.
Honeycomb, me want honeycomb.
I know the feeling. So sweet and
crunchy.
Crunchy.
Yeah, it's like
toasted honey.
Toasted honey.
In that weird shape.
Me want honeycomb now.
Yes.
I mean, let's get some.
Honeycomb!
Honeycomb cereal is an irresistible part of this complete breakfast.
Got a crazy craving for
honeycomb!
Hi. You know why Quaker State asked me to be their spokesman? Because I'm tough. Quaker State is tough. Tough on wear and tough on sludge. If you use Quaker State in your new car's engine, they'll guarantee it for 250,000 miles or 10 years in writing. Quaker State is one tough motor oil. So, naturally, they asked me because I'm tough. You don't think it's because they think I'm oily?
Did you know that you can do yourself and the planet a favor at the same time? Well, you can. It's not cool to take a car when you can walk or jog or ride a bike. Cars add to air pollution, and laziness adds to body pollution. Walk more, drive less, use public transportation. If you stay fit, so will the Earth. Like Captain Planet and the Planeteers say, the power is yours.
You've conquered red. You've mastered blue. You've triumphed over yellow. You've caught them all. And now, you're ready for the next step. Welcome to the world of Pokemon Gold and Silver. Tons of new Pokemon. New adventures and worlds to explore. New badges to collect. So you've got to ask yourself, have you got what it takes? Pokemon Gold and Silver, rated E for everyone. Gotta catch them all. You live to catch Pokemon, but 150 aren't enough. Get ready for the next step. On October 15th, Pokemon Gold and Silver will arrive. You can reserve each copy for $5 and receive this CD-ROM filled with cool Pokemon stuff. You'll get trivia, music, and more. You can log on to Pokemon.com for details. Pokemon Gold and Silver, rated E for everyone. Gotta catch them all.
Get ready!
Cool move, guys!
Cause CBS is the Coolopolis place to be!
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Good job!
Kick it with the Care Bears! And Strawberry Shortcake, too! Cake is oh so crafty!
Oh, I love it!
And Horseland is oh so sassy!
Yeah!
Sushi Pack is on a roll!
Well, sashimiya!
While Dino Squad transforms!
Get prehistoric!
So get ready for Coolopolis! Weekends on CBS!
Junto a Dora la Exploradora, todo es aventura.
¡Desmane!
¡Sorpresa! ¡Oh! Y diversión.
¡Genial!
Y cuando llega Diego, empieza la carrera.
¡Rápido, rápido!
¡A jugar! Y ayudar a los animalitos.
¡Súper rescate!
Ven a Planeta U este sábado a las 8 de la mañana, 7 Centro, por Univisión.
Hey, she's got pigtails.
Yeah.
What's that?
Cattails.
That kind of a tail. What kind of tail is that?
Dragon tail. From the makers of Sesame Street.
They're two of Nick's biggest stars and two of Nick's biggest shows. And they're coming together.
No way, you're iconic!
In the biggest television event of the year.
It's gonna be good.
iCarly.
That girl Carly's really pretty, don't you think?
Meets Victorious.
Joy. Who's she?
In I Party with Victorious. The brand new TV event coming this summer only on Nick.
Yeah, I want you every day. You're so bad. You're so tight. You got my world spinning. You got my world spinning. My head goes round and around.
Make them
I'm thinking? Brownie!
Only Duncan Hines Double Fudge Brownies gives you both chocolate fudge in the batter and a packet of extra fudge. So you get chewy chocolate Double Fudge Brownies.
Mmm, know what I'm thinking?
These are delicious.
Know what else?
Okay.
How to make your moist, delicious best.
Duncan Hines.
I'm Sir Chomps-a-Lot. I've lost control for these little raviolis in this great big bowl.
Do the chomp!
It's a ravioli romp.
Do the chomp!
Your feet got to stomp. Do the chomp! Do the chomp! Do the chomp!
New Chef Boyardee Sir Chomps-a-Lot. Bite-sized beef or cheese ravioli so good and wholesome, you just gotta.
Do the chomp!
Excuse me, while I chomp.
Thank goodness for Chef Boyardee!
Just
Actually, it's kind of exciting, Piggy. I just found this neat alligator staff, see?
I still say stamp collecting is positively boring.
Spam's fun.
Yeah, la. Whoa! And the wolf stopped that.
Sorry.
I think stamp collecting is a blast. Check this out. It's a stamp celebrating the birth of the space age.
Yeah.
whatever that really impressed her.
Gonzo, tie the line on and we'll pull you up.
Yahoo! It's showtime! Annoying arm wrestling, you do stuff you hate, don't lose your head, make them history! Faster! Hey, kids, Ice Capades is celebrating its 50th birthday. And if you're one of the first 2,500 kids at the Friday night, January 26th performance, you'll receive a free Nintendo Watch, courtesy of the Minnesota Dairy Promotion Council, the American Dairy Association, and KMSP. See the Nintendo characters come to life at Ice Capades, January 24th through the 28th at Met Center. Happy birthday, Ice Capades. Remember, January 26th is free watch night for the Minnesota Dairy Promotion Council, the American Dairy Association, and KMSP.
Hey kids, it's Ice Capades' 50th birthday with Nintendo Super Mario Brothers for the first time anywhere live. And Barbie, a real girl, come to life on ice. This is one birthday party you'll never forget. Ice Capades' 50th anniversary.
Experience the magic of Ice Capades, now playing through Sunday at Met Center. Tickets are at Met Center and Ticketmaster or call 989-5151.
New Thunder Jets Fruit Snacks are taking off with Super Fruity F-16s, F-14 Tomcats, SR-71 spy planes, MiG-27s, and the super cool stealth bomber. So top secret, it's not in every pouch. All zooming way past mega scrumptious with a sonic boom of real fruit taste. New power-figured Thunder Jets, the fruit snack that goes fast.
We now return to Muppet Baby.
Come on, guys. If we're going to find Nanny's treasure, we got to search that pirate ship.
You guys go search. I'll stay here and listen to my knees rattle.
Come on, Fozzie. We all stick together.
Yeah, this way.
I can almost smell that treasure. I'll bet it's right under our noses.
I hate to spoil the fun, guys, but I think we found more than treasure.
Could be a
let's grab Nanny's treasure and get out of here.
Okay.
All right, let's go. Hurry!
Wait a minute. What about the pirates? I thought we were going to Broadway.
That was just a trick, Fozzie. Come on!
Okay.
You can see the little lost.
Tomamos el maíz y hacemos ricas burbujas. Y el crunch se lo damos con...
Corn Pops de Kellogg's, la parte deliciosa de un nutritivo desayuno.
Burbujas que hace crunch. ¿Cómo lo hacen?
Lo delicioso de Corn Pops lo hacemos...
Aquí el caso de las deliciosas burbujas que hacen crunch. ¿Por qué son tan deliciosas?
Escogemos el maíz
y hacemos ricas burbujas.
¿Y de dónde viene el crunch?
Corten.
Corn Pops de Kellogg's, la parte deliciosa de un nutritivo desayuno.
¿Burbujas que hacen crunch? ¿Cómo lo hacen?
Lo delicioso de Corn Pops lo hacemos con... Corten.
An apple for the teacher.
Why, thank you, Fuzzy. Ew, yuck! A worm!
Fooled you with the old rubber worm in the apple joke.
That's not funny, Fuzzy. Now go to your seat.
Oh, quit joking around, Fuzzy. It's important to get an education.
You're right, Kermit. There's a time for jokes and a time for being serious. Hey, Skeeter, what's that?
Where?
It's only my fake spider. Pretty funny joke, huh?
No, it's not funny.
I thought you were going to be serious, Fozzie.
Sorry, Kermit. I must have gotten up on the funny side of the bed this morning.
Okay, quiet down, class. The first thing we are going to do is call the roll.
While you're at it, call me a dinner roll. I'm hungry. Waka, waka, waka.
That's enough, Fozzie. In my class, you will raise your hand if you want to speak. Our first subject today will be Italian history. Does anyone know who discovered spaghetti?
I do.
Okay, Gonzo, go ahead.
It was the famous explorer, Marco Weirdo.
Who?
Okay, he was sailing around the world looking for sugar and spice and everything nice when suddenly... the submarine attacked! A submarine sandwich, that is! So Marco Weirdo did the only thing he could. He stuffed his cannons with pizza dough. Spaghetti was born!
That's incredible!
Are you kidding? You should see how I discovered meatballs.
Thank you, Gonzo. You may sit down.
The old whoopee cushion always gets a laugh. Gosh, maybe it's broken.
That won't be the only thing that's broken, Fozzie, if you don't stop goofing off. You're never gonna learn anything.
But I'm going to be a comedian, and I already know how to be funny. Waka, waka, waka.
Sit down! It's time for our arithmetic lesson. Scooter, if you had 10 hot dogs and Skeeter took 3 of them, what would you have?
He'd have a tummy ache. Get it? Waka, waka, waka.
Sheesh.
All right, Mr. Jokester. Let's see if this makes you laugh.
What's that?
It's a dunce cap, you dunce. If you have to tell jokes, then tell them to the wall.
Okay. Hey, Wall, why did the man put a sweater on his hot dog? Because it was a chili dog. Waka, waka, waka.
Report card time!
Let's see.
Wow, I got an A in music.
And I got an A in... cute?
Me get A for animal.
Ha! I got better than an A. I got a W for being weird.
Hey, guys, look at this. I got an F for funny.
Gee, Fozzie, that's not an F for funny. That's an F for not being funny.
Gosh, I thought my jokes would get an A.
Hi, kids. How's your first day at school going?
I got an A in arithmetic, Nanny.
And I got an A in gymnastics.
Well, congratulations. What's the matter, Fozzie? Who wrote this report card?
Piggy did, Nanny.
Giving Fozzie an F wasn't very nice, Piggy. I think you should apologize.
I'm sorry I gave you an F, Fozzie. And I'm even more sorry that your jokes aren't funny.
Piggy!
They are so.
They are not!
Why don't you tell Nanny a joke and let her decide?
Great idea, Kermit. Here's a funny one, Nanny. What's the difference between an orange?
Go ahead, Fozzie. Finish the joke.
It is finished. That's the joke.
See, Nanny?
That was very different, Fozzie.
That's okay, Nanny. You don't have to laugh. I guess Piggy was right. I'm not funny.
Don't give up, Fozzie. With a little more practice, I'm sure you could be a very funny comedian.
Yeah, sure, Nanny.
Fozzie looks awful sad.
Yeah, we can't let him think he's a failure. We gotta help him out.
But how?
We could give him funny lessons.
Oh, that's a great idea, Gonzo. Come on, Fozzie. We're gonna turn you into the funniest bear in town.
You are?
Sit down, Fozzie, and Kermit will show you how to be funny.
Me?
Uh-huh. Ladies and gentlemen, now appearing live in the world-renowned nursery room, the one and only Kermit Danger Frog.
Now remember, Fozzie, the secret to funny jokes is twisting around the meaning of the words.
I knew a guy who was going to start a bakery, only he couldn't raise the dough.
Thank you. Please. What do you get when you cross a frog with an elephant?
You get a flat frog!
Thank you very much! Thank you! You see, Fozzie, it's simple.
And now, the nursery room is proud to introduce a foot and a half of fuzz-covered fun, Fozzie Bear! Yay!
You think I'm ready?
Sure, go on!
It's all in the words.
Don't worry. I got it now. What do you get when you put chocolate pudding in your mother's shoes? Give up? You get a spanking. Waka, waka, waka. Hey. Ow. I thought it was funny.
Sorry, Fozzie. I guess I let you down.
It wasn't your fault, Kermit. My joke just wasn't funny.
That's because the true secret to comedy is craziness.
Then you must be the funniest weirdo in the world, Gonzo.
Be nice to me, Piggy, or I'll tell everybody where you hide your chocolate bonbons.
Okay.
Now, as I was saying, the secret to being funny is being weird. You know, like Steve Martin.
See the people in the audience with the amateur model arrow through the head?
Sorry. Come on, Fozzie. After I give you some weird lessons, you'll have the audience rolling in the aisles. The first thing you need is a weird prop.
Okay.
Fozzie?
Gosh, it's working already.
Wait till you see this. This is what we in the weird business call Weirdsville. Pretty funny, huh?
It doesn't look funny to me.
Did you hear that, fellas? He doesn't think we're funny.
Whoa! I don't get it.
It's simple, Fozzie. What makes something funny is when it's unexpected. Like this.
Okay.
Thanks for trying, pal.
Gee, Gonzo's imagination is dangerous. I'm getting out of here. Gonzo's too weird for me.
And you're not going to.
I'll never find out what funny is.
Nemo.
Animo? What do you know about being funny?
Funny is fun.
Huh?
Funny is trip.
Oh, I get it. People will laugh at me if I trip and fall. Hey, guys, watch this. Wow!
Wow, that was great, Fozzie. I knew you could be funny.
What are you talking about, Kermit? I really did trip.
Oh, sorry.
Now, this is a funny trip. Whoops! Oh! Great, huh?
Sure, Fozzie. That was funny, wasn't it, guys?
I can't even trip right. I'm just not cut out to be a comedian. All I wanted to do is make people laugh. I guess I am a failure.
Gee, what are you doing, Fozzie?
I'm throwing away my joke books and all of my joke stuff. You guys have been right all along. I'm just not funny. I'm giving up comedy for good. I'm tired of trying to be funny.
I know how you feel, Fozzie. It's kind of like playing a song and nobody taps their feet.
Yeah.
Oh, don't give up, Fozzie. If I hadn't given you an F, you would still want to be funny.
It's not your fault, Piggy. After 1,000 tomatoes in the face, I can take a hint.
But making people laugh always meant so much to you, Fozzie. Are you sure you want to give that up?
Uh-huh. I'm going to be the most unfunny thing I can be. Maybe I could sell books. That sounds pretty unfunny.
Who is it?
Door-to-door sales bear.
Oh, come right in.
Okay.
Fozzie! I meant through the regular door.
Oh, I knew that. Good afternoon, miss. My name is Fozzie Bear, and I was wondering if you'd be interested in buying a new 3D holographic stereo encyclopedia.
They're not funny, are they?
Oh, no. They're not funny at all. Here, I'll show you. Oh, sorry. I'm new at this. Oh, Volume E. You'll love this one. Here's a section on earthquakes.
Quick, turn the page. Okay.
Whew, that was close.
What section is that?
Electricity. Yeah.
Maybe volume O is safer.
No, not that page. That's the ocean.
Oh,
whoa! Here it is. Wow!
I said navy, not oranges.
Well, they're naval oranges. I was close. Wait a minute. Maybe there's a section on jokes. Jet planes, jokes. Wow! There's nothing worse than a wise guy encyclopedia. Gosh, what volume is that? Ooh, it's K for Kermit.
I don't think you were cut out to be a sales bear, Fozzie.
Really? I thought I was getting close to a sale. Come to think of it, I'm not very close to anything.
Oh, let's go back to the nursery.
How do we get back?
Check in volume D.
Oh, D for drain. I can't tell jokes. I can't sell books. What good am I?
What kind of attitude is that, Fozzie? You gotta be good for something.
I guess I could always be a bear rug.
Nah, you're too lumpy.
I know what you can be, Fozzie. Don't you get it?
Oh, yeah. I could be a metronome.
No, you like standing up in front of people. You could be a singer.
I could?
Sure you could, Fozzie.
Yeah, go on, give it a try.
Here goes nothing. Yeah! I can see it all now as I walk out on stage. The audience cheers. I'm the latest rage. I grab my guitar and I'm ready to play. And then I reach for the microphone and here's what I say. Waka, waka, waka! Waka, waka, waka!
I don't get it! Waka, 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 and we don't know why!
I guess I'm just a funny guy! The concert's a smash! I'm a famous bear!
Oh,
they chased me around for a lock of my hair! My video's out, and my album, too! And here's what I say on my interview! Waka, waka, waka!
Here he goes again!
Waka, waka, waka!
What's the matter with you? Waka, 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 and we don't know why!
I guess I'm potato.
That's not funny.
Okay, try this one. Knock, knock. Nobody's home.
Yeah.
Waka, waka, waka.
Is he for real?
Waka, waka, waka.
I can't figure it out. He's a waka, waka, waka. We don't know why. Waka, waka.
I can't help it. Waka. I'm a natural. Some bears got it, some don't. Waka. Pretty funny, huh? Gosh, I guess I'm not very good at singing either. It's no use. I'm not funny. I can't sew. I can't sing. I'm just a dumb bear.
You're not dumb, Fozzie.
I'm not?
No way. In fact, with a little bit of study, I'll bet you could be a great scientist.
You think so, huh? Imagine, Fozzie Einstein. Are you sure I'm scientist material, Professor Scooter?
Positive. Why, with a little luck, you could discover the theory of relativity.
Relativity? Wait a minute. I think I got it. Of course. I'm a bear, and bears are related to dogs. Therefore, Ralph and I are relatives. I've just discovered relativity.
No, not quite, Fozzie. Relativity means that something is big only when you compare it to something else that's smaller. You know, it's all relative.
Oh, you mean like relative to a peanut? I got a real big brain.
Something like that.
This science stuff is fun. I think I'll invent anti-gravity chewing gum.
You might be a great scientist, Fozzie, but nobody can invent anti-gravity chewing gum.
Yeah. I guess you're right. Huh?
Wow, you did it! You're a genius, Fozzie!
Gosh, I am, aren't I? I could invent anything. Maybe even a joke formula. I've done it! Instant funny! Huh? Wow!
Instant tomato soup is more like it.
Who am I kidding? I'll never be a scientist. The only formula I ever discovered was baby formula.
I know how you feel, Fozzie. I felt awful when I realized I'd never be what I wanted to be.
What did you want to be, Gonzo?
I wanted to be green, so Piggy would like me better.
Oh, yuck! Beat it, Bugsy!
Fozzie, be.
Thanks, animal, but I don't want to take your toys.
Toys make happy.
Really? Maybe animal's right. Maybe I need toys. Maybe if I made millions of dollars, I could buy myself happiness. Whew. It sure is hot in Texas. Hey, Kermit, wait up!
Huh? Do I know you?
Of course you do. It's me, J.R. Fozzie.
J.R. Fozzie? Gee, I haven't seen you since you left the nursery to become a billionaire.
Yeah, I'm a big oil rancher now, rolling in dough. How about you, Kermit? Did you make a lot of the green stuff?
Nope, the only green I got is my skin. But it's mine, and I'm happy.
So am I. I got everything I could possibly want.
Well, then, I guess you don't need me.
Wait, don't you want to see my oil ranch?
Well...
You're really gonna like it.
Okay.
I've got 1,000 cows. They put out 10,000 barrels of oil a day.
Wow.
And wait till you see this. I got my own airstrip and my own private lake. Yes, sir. There isn't anything in the world I can't buy.
You must be real happy.
Now that you mention it, I'm miserable. I don't understand it, Kermit. I got cars, boats, planes, everything. How come I'm not happy?
I don't know, Fozzie. When was the last time you felt happy?
It was back in the nursery, when I used to tell jokes. not crying. I just had some smoke in my eye.
It just isn't the same anymore without Fozzie telling his jokes.
I know what you mean, Kermit. I never laughed on the outside, but when Fozzie was happy, I always had a smile on the inside.
Come on, let's tell him.
There's something we want to tell you, Fozzie.
Don't worry. I'll never tell another joke again.
You don't understand, Fozzie. We want you to tell jokes.
You do? But I thought you said they were awful, Piggy.
I did.
But she never told you to give up your dream.
That's right, Fozzie.
You mean I can tell jokes again?
Sure, Fozzie.
Go ahead.
We love to hate your jokes.
Oh, boy. Did I tell you the one about the man with the light bulb in his nose? He was lightheaded. Waka, waka, waka. What do you call a zebra with no stripes?
A horse.
A horse. Pretty funny, huh? Oh, yeah? Well, I can do worse than that. How about this one? What do you call a yo-yo that goes down but won't come up? A yo! Wow! Yum! Tomato! Waka, waka, waka!
Our story today takes place in the happy little town known as... Who cares where it takes place? It's not about the town. It's about two brothers, Alan and Tom. Well, it's mostly about this one, Alan. See, Tom is what they call a go-getter. He has what they call school spirit.
What are you doing?
I'm making a list.
For what?
It's for the fundraiser.
A fundraiser list?
Yeah, I forgot. The story kinda has to do with the big school fundraiser.
I'm making a list for all the people that Mom and Dad can talk to see if they'll buy some stuff.
You're kidding, right?
No.
Well, that's about the lamest thing I've ever heard.
Don't you got something else to do?
Well, I could make a fundraiser list.
Don't you got like a spelling bee or something?
Spelling bees are worse.
Oh, one more thing. There's also this big spelling bee, but that's later. Don't worry about that now.
Okay, boys, time for bed.
All right, Mom.
Alan, he has his own talents, but let's just say he's about to learn a valuable lesson. That's where I come in. We got another one! Mr. Big Shot, too good for the rest of us, eh?
Tommy! Tommy!
Listen, kid, I'm 3 feet tall. My favorite food is marshmallows, and they make me wear this hat. Come at it.
Now, should I suddenly get the urge to punch your knee or bite your shoe, I'll send you a memo.
I don't believe in elves.
You don't believe in elves? He doesn't believe... Well, that makes two of us. Listen, let's get one thing straight, kid. I am not an elf. All right? I'm not a troll. And I'm not a leprechaun with their green clovers and blue diamonds. They're a mess. I'm a Nimblingdit.
A Nimbling?
Dit. N-I-M-B-L-I-N-G-D-I-T. Nimblingdit are as happy as can be, cause we sing and we dance. They used to make us sing that song. 50 Nimblingdit singing and dancing. It was a mess. Don't get me distracted.
What do you want?
It's not what I want. It's what you threw out.
The fundraiser?
Hey, we have a genius in our presence. What does he win, Bob? A Thanksgiving turkey? Yes, the fundraiser.
You're here because of the fundraiser.
Well, it was a promotion, really. I used to work with kids with braces, but I couldn't understand the word. It was a mess. Don't get me sidetracked. Let's go.
Go where?
Welcome, welcome. If I had a seat, I'd say have a seat, but in your case, just stand there.
Where are we?
Ah, we are in the magical land of the Nimble. Who cares where we are? The question is not where are we, but why are we? Where are we? We are here. You're confusing me. It won't work. You better hold on to something. Remind me to install something to hold on to. The reason that you are here is so that you can learn a little something called responsibility. First stop, school supplies. Anyone you know? It would appear that you have enjoyed playing with the new playground balls. Is this correct?
How in the world did you get this?
Even after Susie Simmons trounced you 11-4, you still seem to have fun.
Well, I learned.
The point is, where did the school get the money to purchase these new playground balls? It must be nice to be reading from the new library books. Question, where did the school get the money to purchase the new library books?
Fundraisers?
Bingo!
I get your point.
I'm not even warmed up! Hold on! As we journey through the magic land of the Nimblingdits, you will notice that you may not like fundraisers, but you sure like the benefits that come from the fundraisers. Let me guess. Do you like art projects?
Well, everybody likes art projects and stuff.
Is the paint free? Do paintbrushes just fall from the sky into your happy little hands? These things are expensive. Oh, ow! Oh, what is that? My ears! My ears! What? Oh, yes! It is you! Learning to play a musical instrument. The joy, the privilege. Where does the school get the money to purchase these things?
Fundraisers?
They sure help. So why didn't you want to do the fundraiser?
I don't know.
Well, know this. Nice balance. All we're asking you to do is ask mom or dad to ask their friends, family, neighbors, co-workers to pick out what they want to buy from the fundraiser book. Then they write it down on the order form. Then you collect the money from the people right away and put it in the money envelope. Then you turn in your money and the order form on the scheduled turn-in date. Does this sound too complicated?
Well, no.
Well, then you and your family need to try your very best to sell as many things as you can to help your school. Did you like the assembly on the space program?
It was the best.
Assemblies cost money.
I'll do it.
You probably liked all the field trips You got to go on.
I'll do it.
So long, field trips.
I'll do it.
Do what?
Tommy, I had the weirdest... We have to do the best we can for the fundraisers. We need fundraisers for assemblies and music programs. Oh, and field trips. Are you listening?
Let me guess. Elf dude, pointy ears, 3 foot tall?
Whoa!
What was his name? Nibbling? Don't forget your fundraiser book.
I knew this place looked familiar. Well, anyway, I think Alan learned a valuable lesson about responsibility and hard work. And not only for the fundraiser, but also for other things.
Okay, Alan, this is for the championship. Nimblinged it.
Nimblinged it?
Nimblinged it. A make-believe elf-like character that motivates young people.
Right. Nimblinged it. NIMBLINGDIT. Nimblinged it.
Correct!
I've been doing this for a long time, and I try never to play favorites, but I got a good feeling about this kid. I think this just might be the start of greatness.
Guitar makes us sing.
Go where you wanna go, go now.
Each Radio Disney Pop Dreamer sings 2 different songs and comes with 3 cool outfits.
This green dress is gonna make waves.
She tells you what she's wearing.
And when these dolls get together, they sing together. Radio Disney Pop Dreamer. Each sold separately from ThinkWay. CD available from Walt Disney Records.
Why do I always have pimples?
Pimples.
Pimples?
Ugh. Why do I always have pimples?
I tried stuff at night.
I tried scrubbing. Forget it.
I used that stingy liquid stuff.
And that prescription product says it could take weeks to work.
Don't get mad. Get Clearasil. Clearasil cream sucks up oil, then zaps pimples dry.
The choice is clear.
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 The choice is clear.
For clearer skin, the choice is Clearasil.
Bring Fievel home on videocassette and watch him bring fun.
You in the front. Higher, higher.
Laughter. Joy. Tears. And love to your whole family. Steven Spielberg presents An American Tale, a Don Bluth film. Now at video retailers everywhere.
A little cheddar makes plain veggies taste better. But take the cheddar cheese away and you can just say...
No way!
'Cause cheddar cheese makes all the difference.
Hooray!
On all kinds of vegetables, cheese makes all the difference.
We are with you night and day. With the ones you love. When you need it. We are there when you play. While you're working. When you study. We are always with you. LA Care Health Plan. Free or low-cost healthcare programs for a healthy life.
Sunny knows what makes kids cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Real Hershey's Cocoa!
Yeah, you know the stuff.
It's chocolatey! It's outrageous! It's the stuff that makes kids like you cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs!
Chocolatey tasting Cocoa Puffs, a tasty part of this complete breakfast.
Now you can go stir crazy with Hershey's Chocolate Milk Mix. One pack free in marked boxes of these chocolatey cereal.
Oh,
I know I find it. That treasure is right under my nose. That's funny. It sure is wet down here.